Should you invest in cryptocurrencies? Coming up. Hi everyone, this is Dr. Ernesto from Attaboy Cowboy. In this channel, we give you health and wealth tips to help you be more successful. Now today we're gonna talk about cryptocurrencies. I've been getting messages every single day and phone calls about cryptocurrencies. It's skyrocketing. I think today, Bitcoin just reached $47,000 per Bitcoin. And people are looking at that and they're saying, hey, you know, this was just a few dollars like 10 years ago, or even pennies, and now it's 47,000. But the thing is that there's a few things you wanna consider. I'm gonna give you 8 points to consider. And first off, let me explain a little bit about it. Basically, Bitcoin was started about 10 years ago. And out of that, there's been several other types of copycat. There's in the hundreds now of cryptocurrencies. And the basic idea is to make it easy to move money around the world without banks or government regulation. So I'll tell you a story about myself. I was in Florida and someone gave me some money that they owed me and I was driving back to California. And I didn't really think about it, but I had like $17,000 on me, which was a lot of money. And I got pulled over in Tennessee and they called out all these cop cars and the police, you know, they searched me, they put all the money out, they videotaped it, they took pictures, they counted it. It was a big deal. And what I wasn't aware is that passing state lines in the United States, going from state to state with more than $10,000 cash is actually against the law and they can confiscate the money from you. So it's a big deal, even when you travel. If you've ever traveled outside your country, you're gonna see, they're gonna ask in the customs forms, are you traveling with more than $10,000? Everywhere I go in the world, they've asked me that, whatever country. And if you are, you have to declare it, or again, they can confiscate all the money. So I can see how, you know, the cryptocurrencies would be attractive in that sense, where you don't have to have people watching over you. You can move your money around without having any problems, etc. So some of the primary reasons it was started was to help people move money around so it wasn't traced. Who would want that? Well, obviously there's good and bad elements, you know, drug traffickers, terrorists, you know, money launderers, but then there's also people that just are trying to escape paying taxes, etc. You're getting divorced, you don't want your ex-wife or ex-husband to find out how much money you have. So there's a lot of reasons why people want to hide money. And cryptocurrencies basically allow you to do that. Now, let's talk about some of the top questions I get before I get to the eighth. Number one question I get is about asset preservation. People are very nervous right now about all the things that are going on in the world and they're concerned they're gonna lose their money. They're gonna have devaluation. Well, that's something that's always in people's mind. And most of the time, like they say in psychology, 95% of what you worry about never happens. Most likely it's not gonna happen. There isn't gonna be a devaluation. You're not gonna lose all your money. If you think about World War II, they said that a lot of people were selling their assets like in stocks and stuff, and they were putting it into gold. Well, the people that did that to supposedly preserve their assets or their money, they lost their tails. They ended up making less than 1% of what they would have made if they would have just left their money in those stocks. So gold is not a good way to preserve money. I'm not an advocate of precious metals. You could watch some of my other videos. I've had experience with that. I've lost a lot of money in precious metals. It's not a good investment. Cryptocurrencies are very similar. You're not gonna have good asset preservation. So let me get into the top reasons. Tip number one, keep government regulation in mind. There's a lot of money moving in cryptocurrencies. At any time, governments can decide to start regulating it or taxing you on it. That can cause a lot of problems. And another thing is you have to think, if you're a government that has the euro or the dollar or some other major currency, they enjoy having reserve status in the world, which means they make a lot of money off it. They don't want that status to be challenged. Cryptocurrencies are creating an alternative that can challenge that. So the US government or Congress can decide at any moment, hey, you know what? We don't like what's going on here. We're gonna regulate this. We're gonna make it illegal. We're gonna do whatever they want to kind of change that. They can do that at any time. So you're totally at their mercy. So you can invest all your money into it and all of a sudden, boom, the US government or the European Union announces they're gonna do some regulation. Oh man, that would just crash the price. So that's the first thing you have to worry about. Tip number two, you have to depend on other people wanting your cryptocurrency, wanting to buy it. You know, the dollar or the euro, you go somewhere, people want it. They know they can exchange it for goods and services anywhere they go. It's pretty much accepted on the entire planet. But if you have cryptocurrencies, I looked online, only a few hundred retailers, major retailers accept them, that's it. A lot of them do not accept them. So you have to do all these transactions to try to switch it back into dollars or euros to try to use it to buy something. That's a pain. I remember when I used to go to Europe before they had the euro, just across the border from France to Italy to, you know, Switzerland, Germany, whatever, you had to convert your currency every time. And every time they charge you a fee, 2-3%, 2-3%. They just charge you a percentage. And if you got stuck with coins, that's it. Nobody would take them in the next country. So those you pretty much had to give them away or throw them away or something. So it's very inefficient. You lost a lot of money. You can imagine those businesses in the European Union, how inefficient it was for them. So having the euro has been very beneficial. But with cryptocurrencies, again, you're exposed to all these inefficiencies. I checked all the different blockchain and the different trading platforms and everything. Most of them charge you processing fees. You're gonna be charged fees. So you're gonna lose money moving back and forth into dollars or whatever currency you use to actually buy food and pay your rent. Tip number three, and this is actually a good thing. Big banks like Goldman Sachs are starting to open up exchanges to trade cryptocurrencies. So a lot of people are looking at that as a positive. They're saying, wow, that means it's accepted. That means it's a good thing. Don't make assumptions. That's not what it means. They're banks. They want to make profit. They'll invest in whatever they can make a profit in. So if people are buying and selling them, they'll open an exchange so they can charge you fees on it. That way they can keep track of what you're doing, relay that to governments. And also, like I said, they can make profit off it. So it's purely profit motivated. They're not saying that they agree with it or they think it's a good investment strategy. Tip number four, and this works for and against you. Most people don't understand how it works or what it is exactly. So it creates FOMO, fear of missing out. And I think that's why a lot of people are investing in it. They look at the news, they see, oh, cryptocurrency just went from, you know, 1,000 to 20,000. Then they had this big crash and then it goes up and down. Then all of a sudden now it's 47,000 because Elon Musk announced yesterday he was gonna invest $1.2 billion in it. Well, if everybody's looking at that and they're saying, wow, Elon Musk, you know, all these famous people are buying it, I'm missing the boat here. I better jump in, I don't wanna miss money. Everybody wants to make money. That's why I've been researching it, because I wanted to see if this was a viable investment strategy. So that's one thing you wanna make sure you don't get caught up in, don't get caught up in the hype. Tip number five, remember, at the end of the day, Bitcoin doesn't produce anything. There's nothing that it actually offers in terms of value. If you have the dollar or you have some other currency, there's some value there. You can go and trade it. It's backed by a government. I know here in the United States, bank deposits are FDIC insured up to, I think, $300,000 or $400,000. So your money is protected in case there's ever a run in the bank or there's a default or there's embezzlement or anything like that. So there's some security there. But with a cryptocurrency, there is no security. There's no one backing you up. Tip number six, as I mentioned before, don't get caught up in the hype. You know, there's a lot of people that are investing in it right now. I heard that Snoop Dogg is investing in Dogecoin. So he's calling himself Snoop Doge. And Elon Musk just announced he's investing $1.2 billion. And I really respect and admire both of those people because they're really cool. And they have a lot of interesting things. But I gotta be honest, I think they're just playing on the hype to make profit off suckers. Unfortunately, most of the people I'd say 99% or more that invest in cryptocurrencies or alternative investments right now that are very risky and have a lot of ambiguity. There are people that don't know much about investing, don't know much about personal finance. And these people that are famous, they jump in, they buy something, they make a lot of publicity around it, they put it all over social media. You know, all these millennials and all these people that are not real informed about personal finance jump in, and that drives the hype. Now, that could be a good thing if you knew how to time the market, but nobody has a crystal ball. So they buy these large amounts of cryptocurrency, they advertise it, price goes up, and then they just sell, they get out of it. And they leave a lot of people just holding the bag. So those 99% of people end up losing all their money. So I think when you follow people like that, you're kind of playing into the game. You're like a sheep going off to get slaughtered. Okay, tip number 7. So recently we just had the big run up on Reddit of people buying GameStop, AMC, BlackBerry, all this kind of stuff. And a lot of people were kind of prodding it, and they were saying, wow, these guys were battling against the Wall Street investors and against all the investment titans. You know, at the end of the day, who lost? They lost. I have a lot of friends that lost a lot of money in that, and they thought they were in this fantasy that they thought they're gonna beat these big banks. That's not what happened. What happened was initially they caught all these big banks off guard. So sure, they were making money off them, but these sophisticated investors know how to read trade volumes, which is fundamental to stock trading. So they see the movements of the money. All they do is bet against their position. So they'll make money where it's going down or going up. If they can go into Reddit just like anybody else can. They can read what's going on there, what people are pushing. They can start investing for or against stocks. So they ended up making a lot more money. Sure, initially they lost some money, but they ended up making more money at the end of it. So at the end, these sophisticated investors ended up taking advantage of all these rookie investors. And I think that's what's happening with cryptocurrencies. So much hype, so much people are jumping into it, you know, and they're just gonna get slaughtered. They're gonna lose all their money. Tip number 8, it's a type of speculative investing, like gambling. So people always like to speculate. You know, everybody dreams of putting a dollar into something and getting $10,000 or getting $47,000 out of it. Of course, everybody does. And that happens once in a, who knows, it's like getting hit by lightning. Doesn't happen very often. So at the end of the day, cryptocurrencies are mostly speculative investing. Now, I've been investing for over 20 years. I've had my ups and downs, and no form of investing is perfect. There's always risk, but there's managed risk. You know, there's calculated risk. There's things that you look at economic and maybe financial fundamentals for your investments. You can figure out things. But when you have speculative investing, there's big surges and big downfalls in prices. That's not a good investment strategy. It's just too much exposure. It doesn't really bode well for a future if you're trying to invest for the long term. So again, thank you for listening. And if you have any comments, please comment below from Elysian Park, Los Angeles. This is Ernesto from Attaboy Cowboy. Goodbye.